everyone. Today, we are going to see George Bernard Shaw's play, Candida. George Bernard Shaw is famous for his role in revolutionizing comedic drama. He was a literary critic and a prominent British socialist, with the range of incorporating both contemporary satire and historical allegory. He became the leading dramatist of his generation. Shaw wrote several plays with political themes during his period. These plays dealt with issues such as poverty, women's rights, and implied that socialism can help to solve the capitalist problems. Shaw, being an iconoclastic, had taken up the mission to discard the existing social order in the society. Candida play was written in the year 1895, comes second in the collection called Plays Pleasant and is subtitled Herb Mystery. The play is often categorized as a comedy, an anti-romantic play, and a drama full of ideas. It is the story of eternal triangle that Shaw deals within an unconventional way. Shaw provides plentiful scope for exposing his characters that were prevalent in the late Victorian social institution of marriage. Let us now see into the title of the play. The title of the play, Candida, is the name given to the central character which holds our attention from the beginning to the end. The word Candida is derived from the word candid, which means frank and truthful. The title justifies the name of the heroine, who is frank, bold, confident, and truthful. She is an open book and is outrightly transparent in her outlook and behavior. The play has also a subtitle, A Mystery. It refers to the ending of the play. When Eugene, after having been rejected by Candida, goes out, he utters mysterious words saying, "I have a better secret than that's in my heart." This line is about a mystery that is new to us as readers. And it's also a mystery for Candida, moral. This secret may be about Candida's love for him. It may be about the realization that is fatal to chase worldly happiness. Nothing is definitive, and so the subtitle is as appropriate as the main title. Let's now look into the characters of the play. The main character is Candida. As her name suggests, she is a bold, frank, and truthful woman. She is physically attractive, mentally alert, and morally she is impeccable. She is 33 years old of age, well-built, well-nourished, and a charming lady. Then comes another character, Eugene Marchbanks. Eugene Marchbanks is one of the most interesting characters in the play Candida. He is a young poet of 18. He is slight, shy, and effeminate with a delicate, childish voice. Then comes another character, husband of Candida, James Mabor Morrill, is a Christian socialist. He is a popular man of 40. He is a robust and good-looking man. He is loved and admired for his first-rate sermons and lectures. He has high ideals and aspirations in his life. Then comes Burgess, the father of Candida. Burgess is a minor character in the play. His aim in the play is to provide comic relief. He helps Morrill add his views on socialism as he justifies his bourgeois ideology. Prospain. Miss Prospain Garnett is an efficient typist of James Morrill. She is a woman of about 30 and belongs to the lower middle class. In fact, she is representative of her class, hardworking, efficient, self-respecting, but easily tempted by costly things of comfort and luxury. Then comes Lexi Mill. Lexi Mill, the curate of Morrill, is an educated young man. He has received his education at Oxford. He is proud of his education. He is unaware of the fact that, like many other young women of his age, he is devoid of originality. Plot of the play. The plot of the play is not very complex. It moves in a linear direction. The entire action takes place in James Morrill's drawing room. It begins in the morning and ends by 10 o'clock in the night. The focus is on the internal action, as the main aim of the playwright is character development through interactions. The exposition in the first act is happening quickly. We learn at once about James Morrill, his popularity as a preacher, his higher ideals, etc. The conflict between ideas is brought home with the clash of ideas of Morrill and his father-in-law, Burgess. Morrill represents socialism while Burgess represents capitalism. Then the entry of Eugene Marchbanks, a lad of 18 and a poet, initiates the main conflict. He shocks Morrill by saying that he treats his wife, Candida, as his slave, and then by declaring that he is in love with Candida. Candida's subsequent entry is important. Her handling of the two men is clever. Eugene Candida relationship disturbs the even tenor of the life of the Morrill. Clashes and encounters crop up. Candida is forced to choose between Morrill and Eugene. The suspense is maintained till the end. The resolution of the conflict is sudden and surprising. If Candida had chosen Eugene as commonly expected, it would have made the play melodramatic. Candida's return to her husband shows how appearances are essential to be kept up in society. Like Shaw's other heroines, she shows wisdom in keeping her emotions under check. She cannot opt for a life of isolation and incompleteness with Eugene. The ending of the play is a mystery also. We are eager to know the secret in Eugene's heart. We get engaged in thinking about it. As the plot advances, there is a clear development in the characters of James Morrill and Eugene Marchbanks. By the end of the play, Morrill is a changed man. His illusions about the worth of his ideas as a preacher and his notion about man's superiority in man-women relationship are shattered. He admits to Candida, "You are my wife, my mother, my sisters. You are the sum of all loving care for me." The sudden and unexpected change in Eugene Marchbanks' character is considered to be a flaw in the plot of the play. The Eugene of the last scene is totally different from the Eugene of the first scene, which makes him not one but two characters. Candida's choice has also been seen as a damn squib. Despite these flaws, the plot of the play is effective in achieving the playwright's overall aim and making the play a theoretical success. The play ends with Marchbanks' secret undisclosed, justifying the subtitle of the play Candida. Readers are eager to know the mystery of the poet's Eugene's mind. Thank you.